Hey guys, this is Alex from Games and Me. Just wanted to post this new show. It's called Community Playlist. Now, what does that mean exactly? Well, I told you guys before that we actually watch a lot of videos here on YouTube, so we want to kind of return the favor to all our fans and stuff and kind of show you guys like what we really like from your videos. And kind of like almost kind of like an indirect kind of shout-out almost, you know, it's like it's being very specific as to what we like in terms like of like your videos and stuff like that. And before that, I want to preface this by basically doing a shout out for Magus X1, Pete Dore, Happy Console Gamer, and Queens of the Pwn Age. Now those guys have been like really like instrumental in helping like Games and Me kind of like be where they're at today. Because you know like obviously Magus and Pete basically like giving us a shout out, and we've really met a lot of their community, which is really awesome. Now, for Happy Console Gamer, it's kind of the same thing. It's like, we really like, you know, like, the kind of quality that he puts in his videos and the amount of work that he does, and, you know, that's really, really cool. And of course, Queens of the Pwn Age, they're really funny guys. You gotta go check them out. And I'm pretty sure, like, you know, we're kind of coming into Games and Me as kind of, like, fans of all these guys already, but just to make sure, if you guys aren't fans of these guys yet, make sure you subscribe to all their channels, like all four of these channels that I mentioned and stuff. So, let's go into the videos. So, the first video I want to talk about is Retrocalypse Impressions of Avalon Code. Now, I was kind of curious about the game, and I actually found that Retrocalypse actually had something to say about it. And apparently it was requested by both Pete Dore and Splatter Trigger, so I kind of watched it and stuff. What really fascinated me was the fact that it was actually very informative, and it went really in-depth with the story. But it's not, like, very spoilerific, in my opinion. And it was enough for me to basically buy the game. And yeah, I'm already broke. And here's the proof of the pudding. Proof in the pudding, rather. Here's Avalon Code. I still have to make an unboxing video for this. And next one is actually Twilight Halo with his Killzone 2 review. Now, I kind of noticed he was kind of getting reamed by all the comments and stuff, so I kind of had to watch and see, like, what he had to say about the game. Now, he's not a system hater or anything like that, but, you know, like the comments suggest, I mean, he's just very strong about his opinions of games and stuff. And I can kind of see where he's coming from. Now, coming out with views like this is very, very ballsy. And, you know, he's not doing it to intentionally piss people off, you know. So, to the haters, it's from his personal experience, you know. Not everybody's going to like Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen. But I can guarantee you there's at least one person that's going to like it. And no, I'm not trying to compare Killzone 2 with Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, okay? So, the next one is by ET Reviewing. It's his video called Recent Purchases Number 2. Now, what's interesting in this video, he basically talks about the games that he got, and he's like a kid. Where does he get his money? And he doesn't have a lot of views or subscribers, but I wanted to mention this because I want to encourage him to make more videos and stuff, and to increase his, and I wanted to increase his exposure to the community. So when you get a chance, definitely check him out. It also kind of reminds me of when I was a kid, you know. I mean, you know, I played a game as soon as I got home and stuff, and I was really excited to play all these games and stuff like that. And I wanted to play as many games as possible. And then again, the question, you know, is brought up, like, where the hell does he get the money? But anyways, he's actually very knowledgeable. And he's very tech-savvy. Like, there was this one time he was actually uploading, like, an HD footage, like, online. I'm like, what are you doing? You know, it was very, very surprising. And the recent purchases series that he's making is a kind of like a mix of what he picked up and kind of like his opinions of the games and stuff. And I thought that was really, really cool of him to do. So definitely check it out. Next one is by, obviously, he's actually our 400 subscriber, so welcome to the family. The specific video I want to talk about is this Macross Retro Commentary. Now, he talks about an obscure game that came out, that never came out in the United States, that I personally played in the Philippines, which is basically based off of Macross, which is, in Japan, is called Super Dimensional Fortress Macross. It's kind of like a shooter type game where you have like a transforming, like, you know, robot and stuff like that, which is really cool. And what struck me about this is the fact that he plays the game while he's doing the commentary. And I have to say that that's really, really tough to do. I mean, when we tried doing this on Games and Me back in August when we were starting this whole thing, we spent like maybe 5 hours like just sifting through it and absolutely having no content on it. So this is like really, really, really cool that he he's doing that. So definitely props for you, obviously. No pun intended. He actually describes the game real well, too, which is, again, it's, you know, like, you're kind of distracted by the screen and stuff. And the last thing you want to do is, oh, I need more detail with this, you know? That's really, really cool. The next guy is Forest Lock. It's basically his Shin Megami Tensei Persona 4 review. Now, one thing they have to say about Forest Lock's reviews, great editing, very well thought out. If we had a lot of time here at Games and Me, we'd actually want to put our reviews to like this almost the same level as his and stuff, because he really put a lot of thought into it. And what's cool is he mixes the narrative and the gameplay. So, I mean, you don't see Forest Lock on there, but it's really cool that you see the gameplay and stuff like that too. And I have to say, that's really super tough to do. Imagine, he probably had to have a save in every single important moment the entire game, and have already planned out how he's going to lay out the review and stuff like that on screen, and what you're going to be seeing while he's playing through the game, which is absolutely fantastic. You know, I mean, that's just insane. What's cool is he also has some rigid sectioning, so basically he talks about the story, he talks about gameplay and all that other aspects, which is kind of cool. He also has some great transitions where he actually uses some of the gameplay sections of the game to kind of lead into like some of the things that he's going to talk about, which is great. Very highly detailed, highly recommended if you want to check it out. And if you're not sure if you want to pick up Persona 4, that's definitely a review to kind of check out. Next one's by Steals Forever. It's specifically his Weekend Pickups number 4. He's a very charismatic dude. He has a great personality. Basically, the video is kind of similar to ET reviewing. It's the stuff that he basically picked up recently and stuff. And then what's cool is he kind of tells you a little bit about his gaming history, so you kind of know there's a context to which, like, where he's coming from and stuff. And that's very important because, like, somehow there are people that have basically played certain games. And that's, I think, why reviews don't work, is sometimes people don't play certain games, so individual experience is going to be varied and stuff. So definitely, like, something great that he does and stuff. And we were kind of hoping we're kind of do that in a What Kind of Gamer Are You series, like, for Games and Me, but not to the same extent as Steels, of course. But yeah, we wanted to talk to him about Xbox Live, but we haven't been able to contact him and stuff, but... On that note, add me on Xbox Live PSN. It's Attorney in Black. I know that's totally side, you know, it's like on the side and stuff, but just bring it out there anyway. Next one is Jumble Junkie. Jumble Junkie's pretty funny. He's a hilarious guy. This video is behind the scenes outtakes of Bloopers Volume 2. Now, this is kind of weird. It's not really too gamey. This is just a lot of comedy stuff. This is actually what made me subscribe to Jumble Junkie, to be honest. It shows you how much of a personality he can be, like, even if he's not on camera, and even if, you know, some of his scenes are, like, kind of cut out, which is really great. And, you know, like what Jumble Junkie said, you know, he didn't invent outtakes. We kind of agree, but he just made it enjoyable to watch over and over and over again. You know where I'm getting with this. So, and the last one is basically Any Game Zone, which is... specifically the video that says Any Game Zone Top 3 Game Developers Part 1 Episode 4. Now that sounds really confusing, and I have to put this disclaimer. I am a member of their panel, and it's a very fun panel. It's filled with a ton of YouTube personalities and stuff. Some, you know, some already established, some, you know, just getting there and stuff. And it's actually really, really, really funny, like genuinely funny. Like you'll suddenly start seeing like some of their personalities the more you listen to it. This kind of proves that you don't need to be confined by, like, YouTube's 10-minute time limit. When I basically jumped on this panel, I basically said, you know what? You gotta let your personality out. Because, you know, you don't want to be, like, this very sterile type of panel and stuff like that. It's kind of not interesting. Because, I mean, it's cool that you're talking about serious stuff, but you need to have some sort of light to it so that people can actually keep on, you know, watching and stuff. And it's very easy to start a panel. Basically, the main reason why I picked this is because I wanted to show everybody how easy it is to basically take all your friends, YouTube or Xbox Live or whatever, and kind of like start talking about games. Don't you do that already? And the funny part about this, we were only going to do one panel. And the funny part about that is we did another one right after that. And it took another hour. So, all right, well, in case you guys kind of missed all that, we actually just got we just started a playlist called the Community Playlist. Duh, it's the name of the show. So, I mean, if you want to check them out, just go to the Community Playlist. And that's where we're basically going to post every single video that we kind of talk about during the week. And we're going to try to do this as weekly as possible. So make sure that you make a ton of videos so we can actually watch them. And we'll see you guys later.